All right. Everybody, welcome to Boosie Speaks. I told you already, we are using the hashtag Boosie Speaks. This is all being streamed live on BoosieSpeaks.com. Again, everyone, please put your phones on silent. And we are going to get started. Now, I'm Angela Yee from The Breakfast Club. You can also hear me out here in New Orleans on Q93. So shout out to everybody here from Q93. What's up, Webby? All right, and I'd like to welcome Boosie's family. His family is here, and everybody from Trill Entertainment. You can see Webby's here, Bun B is here, Jeezy's here, so we're going to have a good time. You know, Mardi Gras just passed, and we are having a celebration. This is a celebration. We are welcoming Boosie. He's home, so. Shout out to everybody from Atlantic Records that's here right now in the building. Mike Kaiser right there. What's up, Kais? Okay. Now, today you are going to get to ask questions, and I'm going to ask some questions too. We're moderating this. Also, we took some questions from off of Twitter. We have a lot of press people here. And I just want to thank everybody for coming out. Thanks to, you know, I'm happy to be here. I think this is a monumental occasion for everybody who's a fan of Lil Boosie. And I'm sure all of us in here are fans and are supporting his career. So we are streaming worldwide, like I said. And we are going to discuss some things with Boosie. He is in the building, so let's get ready for that. But in the meantime, we do have Bun B here. What's up, Bun?
How you doing, Ed?
And we would love for you to say some words. You know, obviously, the first time I ever met Boosie was with you when I was at Sirius. You brought him up to the show. You brought him and Webby up to the show. So I know you've known him since the beginning of his career. So it would be great if you could get up and say some words about Boosie and what it means for Boosie to be home.
Oh, absolutely. I don't need a microphone, bro. Okay.
How's everybody doing today? All right, first of all, I want to thank everybody that came from out of town to support us today. This is a big day for Trill Entertainment. This is a big day for the family of Lil Boosie. And this is a big day for hip-hop. There's been a lot of people, unfortunately, in hip-hop that have been incarcerated. And because of the system, we haven't been able to keep these people's movement alive. We haven't been able to keep people's names fresh. But we've been blessed to the fact that the people stood up and the people wanted to make sure that when Boosie came home, that he knew that the streets loved him. They was waiting for him. They appreciate him and they support him. So again, I want to thank all the regular people that are here, all the news media that are here today. But most importantly, I want to thank the hip-hop community for being here and standing in arms with Lil Boosie. So a lot of people trying to put salt in the game right now. Now, you'd be surprised to see how many people don't want to see a young black man come home from prison and succeed. But we're going to put an end to that kind of talk, that kind of mentality. We're going to show people the reality is that when you keep it 100 with the people will wait as long as possible to stand up for you. They waited years for Mandela. They waited years for Pimp C. They waited for Pac. And they waited for Boosie. And Boosie is home, and we can't be more than happy for that. You know what I'm saying? So on behalf of the family, on behalf of the record company, on behalf of the game, I want everybody to make sure that we give Boosie a nice, warm welcome home. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you so much, Ben. And we also have Young Jeezy here. Now, Young Jeezy is the Senior Vice President of A&R at Atlantic Records, also a Def Jam recording artist. And, you know, we were all out with Boosie last night for dinner, and I would love for Jeezy to get up and talk about the importance of Boosie to the hip-hop community, to everybody in general, and just welcome him home as well.
What up, though?
Give me the other one, okay?
Give it up.
Which one up?
Check, check. Oh, what up, though? How everybody doing out there, man? First of all, I want to say, you know, Boosie, we miss you, your family, your friends, the streets, everybody, man. I remember talking to Boosie while he was incarcerated, and one thing I give him is that he never at one time ever made me feel, or I never heard him feel like the system broke him. Every time I talked to him, he was in the highest spirits, and every time I talked to him, he just talked about coming home. And I remember I used to tell him, I said, yo, Boo, these people out here waiting on you, man. And he'd be like, no, young. I'd be like, no, they waiting on you, homie. So to see, you know, my brother come home, I done did everything from Boosie, from giving out toys to the kids in Baton Rouge. I was going to Houston one day for a show, and Boosie called me on my tour bus, and I had to bust a U-turn and go all the way back to Baton Rouge and pass out toys with the kids. But just to see what he did for his people, his community, man, we just want to welcome him back home. It's a big day for hip-hop. Mama Boosie, you know, she used to come see me when he was down. Him and the kids, TQ, man, y'all doing a great job. And all I got to say is, man, welcome home, Boosie. We miss you, bro. Real talk.
Thank you, Jeezy. And this might be unexpected, but I would love if Webby, since you're here. Come on, Webby. You got to welcome your man home. You got to. I would love for Webby to get up here. Come on, Webby.
Hey, everybody, man. Come on, they told me I want to sit by you. They told me I wasn't going to have to talk. How everybody doing? For real, I'm going to start it off first with God real. God real. If you can be whatever you want to be, tell the kids that. You can be whatever you want to be. But anyway, you can ask. You see, I'm scared. You mean? Anyway, you can ask Boo. He'll tell you. You know, it's nobody, I don't care with him. But anyway, I told him. I say, Boo. I say, you know, it was stuff. They were talking about life and all that stuff. I say, man, God, I talked to God, bro. I say, you coming home, bro. I say, the thing is, it'll be ready when you get here. So when you get out. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
You was really holding it down for him, though. I would say while he was locked up, I would say you definitely was holding it down for Boosie. That's why I felt it was important for you to say some words. Was last night the first time you saw him since he came home?
Yeah. Wait, come on, man.
All right.
Yeah, okay, make a
you sat in the chair. You sat in the chair.
Oh, I can sit here, babe. I'm a king. The leader. Straight up. For real, though.
But no, when we think of Boosie, we think of Webby. When we think of Webby, we think of Boosie. So I think it's only fitting for you to welcome your brother home.
I definitely understand. I tell everywhere I go. If my name come up, his name come up. And yes, I'm just happy. I don't care what happened.
Right.
You know, I'm going to tell him again. Excuse my language. I say, Boosie, man, them niggas, pussy, come on. But look, here we go. So, B, you can listen to me, give me a hug. B, you can listen to me, or you can... You know, me and B, that's my brother for real, man. Talking about fights, all that. Rest in peace to Bleak. I told him a lot of people ain't gonna be here when you get back, man. But I'm gonna be here. I said, thanks. And rest in peace to Bleak. Rest in peace to my little brother Fat. He was a part of the Trail family. Rest in peace to Spade. He was a big motivational person to me and Boo. Everything. Come on, man. Let's make it happy, man. Let's be good today.
All right,
let's do it. What we doing next? I'm out here. Let's go.
All right, thank you. Okay. Now, we also have little Boosie's mom here, and that would be great for his mother, who clearly has known him longer than all of us, to come up here and say some words. So. Give it up for Boosie's mom.
I'm Miss Hatch, and I just wanted to thank everybody, all the supporters, everybody that helped us. But most of all, I always give praises to God, because I know if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be here. So again, I just thank you, and get ready for him, because everything is moving now in the right direction. Thank you.
Now, I know everybody has a lot of questions about what happened with Boosie legally, how he ended up going to prison. So what we're going to do is we do have his lawyers here today. So any questions that have to do with him going to prison, the case and all of that, and there's still some ongoing things, we'll talk to the lawyers about that. We're not going to address Boosie about that specifically because he can't really comment on it. But we do have his lawyers here, so let's welcome them. We do have our Roy Mon, Carl Moore, and James Johnson.
Yeah, there's two here.
Hey, now, come on, let's get them to the one in the second level.
They ain't got no cup.
You know what?
We can hear you.
People going to see them out there. Oh, yeah.
So all of this is going to be just addressing basically what happened with Boosie and his case and all of that. So if you want to break it down, you know, for us, that would be great.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity to be here today and to speak on behalf of Boosie, the Trill family, and Atlantic Records. Roy Mon. First, I'd like to say to Atlantic Records, thank you very much for the support that has been rendered to us both in the past and in the present. They've made Boosie's coming home easy. They've made it smooth, and there are great things that have been put in place and in store for him in cooperation of Trill Entertainment and Atlantic Records. I'll quote Craig Kalman, the co-COO of Atlantic Records, wherein he said, "We bet the building on Boosie." And I'm glad to hear that those words. Some of you may have heard that last Wednesday Boosie was released following 52 months of incarceration. Upon his release, he has served all of the time that is required of him of all the criminal offenses of which he has been responsible during the term of his life. Now, his release is not without conditions. He is currently on probation and will remain on probation possibly as long as 4 more years. He has a hearing coming up in court this Thursday. These gentlemen will speak to those issues, but at that time, it's a routine matter. It's nothing regarding any offense that he may have committed. It's nothing regarding any charges that are hanging over his head. He knew when he came out that he would have a period of probation. In connection with that, he reports to the court. The court will hear, hopefully identify with the circumstances of his career, and will give him the opportunity and the leniency that he needs to go out and to make the most of the opportunities that await him. Boosie's return has been highly anticipated. He is today one of the most well-known and one of the most trend-setting artists in the urban community. We're very, very thankful to have him as part of the Trill family. I know that Boosie has a supportive family, and they're going to help him to be successful in what is ahead. His mother, Connie Hatch, I heard last night, just recently retired from a long tenure in education, teacher or principal, 30 years. She just recently retired. I know that she will be missed because she was an icon at the schools where she worked. Boosie's brother, particularly to Corey Hatch, I want to give make sure his name is mentioned. He's been someone likewise who has been supportive of Boosie and has worked very hard to be sure that now that he's home, the most can be made of the opportunities that are there for him. In the words of a song that's out there right now, spinning wildly on the radio, it's time to show the world. There'll be questions at the end, but right now we'll turn the mic over to these other gentlemen for some remarks.
Good afternoon. I'm here with Attorney James Johnson to speak on the criminal side of Mr. Hatch's situation. He's here today based on the work and the programs that he completed while in custody. He was scheduled to be released in November, but due to his hard work and all the programs that he completed, he's been released, as he mentioned earlier, last week. There is a hearing this Thursday, like he mentioned, that's routine. And he's totally compliant with all of the things that he's being required to do as far as parole and probation.
Just want to reiterate, James Johnson, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for being here. It's been a long road. I just want to say that Boosie has done everything he can to make this thing go as quickly as possible with regards to his incarceration. Right now, he is in compliance with everything. There's not one thing that he has not done that probation and parole, the state of Louisiana, Department of Corrections have requested him to do after his release last Wednesday. So at this particular time, we want to say thank you to him, to the family. Took those long roads up and down that road. We were doing what we could do for Boosie. And while incarcerated, Boosie was doing what he could do for us in order to get out early. And so we want to give him a round of applause and thank him for being a model person. And all I used to tell him when I used to go on that long road, when you get out, it's yours, baby. Mm-hmm. And it's his now, all right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you so much. And with that, you know.
That question will be on the side.
We're not going to do these questions yet, but if you guys have questions for his attorneys, you know, you will have the opportunity to ask them. But Lil Boosie is here, so if y'all want to hear from him, maybe now would be a good time to bring him out. Let's do it, Boosie!
Yeah.
All right. I saw Boosie last night. He said, I don't want to talk about no, you know, Breakfast Club type stuff. So, but we are going to, let's talk about how does it feel for you to be home now? You're home finally. There were a lot of false dates at first, but now you're here in the flesh. You know, your daughter made it clear. I told y'all. So how does it feel? Yeah,
they said I had more release date than Jordan. You know? So I think it was just a lot of people anticipating me coming home, you know, wanting me home. Mm-hmm. But right now, I just feel like some good dreams I had in jail, you know. So right now, I'm just really still enjoying the moment, being with my family, all the people who looked out for me, all the people who loved me, you know. So right now, it's really just about soaking in my time with my kids and really the studio, you know, because that's been my main focus.
Now, what was the first thing you did when you got out of jail? We saw on TMZ, they were like, oh, here's Boosie with his kids. He's in the mall. He's, you know, going shopping. That's the first thing. But I'm sure before you hit the mall, there was something else you did. So what was the first thing?
Oh, the first thing I did as soon as I got out the gates, I went to Baton Rouge and picked my kids up. My lawyers were saying, no, you can't go to Baton Rouge. My mom and everybody say, I'm going to get my kids. So I went straight, got my kids, and we just went played at the hotel all night. That's the first thing I did.
And how many children do you have?
A football team. I got seven.
Seven children, okay.
Yeah.
All right, and we did see, actually, your daughter. She posted on Instagram. She was so excited that you were coming home. Now, Instagram wasn't even around, I think, 5 years ago. So was that weird to you to see it go viral like that?
Yeah. See, I had never seen Instagram. I heard about it, so it was a new experience seeing it. I was surprised when I looked on my iPhone and you could look at people and talk on the phone. So I was used to that, so I was like, the world had changed, you know? Yeah.
Now, were you getting conjugal visits while you were in prison?
No, I wasn't getting conjugal. I visited by myself, though. I visited.
You had a lot of self-love.
Yeah, the warden laid me out. Like, I had my own room, my own TV, and stuff like that. Because when I was visiting with the regular people, they was getting mad because I was signing autographs. And I almost got in trouble for signing a little girl autograph. They wanted to write me up because they told me don't do it. But the little girl came up to me crying.
So you can't say no.
No, I can't say no. She'll remember that the rest of her life.
Right. Then you look like a jerk because I didn't. And I know you were big into magazines because when I interviewed you before, you said you just really like to read magazines. You weren't into like the DVDs and all of that and going online.
Right, I wasn't into it. I read magazines, but I didn't really listen to music when I was in it. You know, I just focused on my music. Mm-hmm. And I didn't even know really the new rappers unless I read about them in the Hip Hop Weekly.
Oh, okay.
You know, so I wasn't too much on people's music. I was just focusing on me.
So when you came out, you did put out a song with you and Webby. Was that a song that you did before you went in, or was it?
Yeah, I did that before I went in.
Okay, so you said, okay, I'm out. Let's just throw something out, and you did a freestyle as well.
Yeah, that Show the World song. We had Ben did that song, and we just had it in the pocket, waiting on me to get short. So we took it out of the pocket, and you know, now it's moving up real good. Supposed to be shooting a video soon.
Okay. And then there was also a song that I saw that you did with C. Murder, and supposedly you're doing a collaboration album. Is that really happening? You know, you read a lot of things
online. I take care of my, I got bigger business and other stuff to do first, you know. Mm-hmm. But I like to help him out on that end, you know, but I want to see C. Murder come home, you know. That's a real dude. You know?
Now, you said you didn't really listen to a lot of other music, but you did hear about a couple of different artists. Was there anybody that stuck out in your mind?
They probably stuck out as me seeing them, but I never listened to their music. Mm-hmm. So I didn't know what they were talking about. You know, I was seeing their success as far as magazines, but I never got into them deep, you know.
Okay. How much music would you say you did while you were in jail?
I wrote 1,018 songs.
1,018 songs?
Yeah.
Damn, that's crazy. So now what's the plan with those 1,018 songs?
Well, I've been in the studio almost every night, so I'm working on the album. We're working on the album right now, so I'm working, you know. Like, every free time I get away, I'm going in the studio. Yeah.
Now, I know a lot of people have been coming out to see you, wanting to say, okay, what's up, Boosie? You got a deal? What's the situation? What is your current situation?
You know, before I left, I was signing a trio. Mm-hmm. And we finna reconstruct this contract. We're getting the album together right now. We're gonna make it happen, you know. We're gonna get back to the money, you know. And Atlantic, they pushing it. They say they gonna push it. You know, I got people at Atlantic who gonna ride for me. You know, I got G's over there at Atlantic. Mm-hmm. What's that tall dude name?
That's Kaiser right there.
Yeah, I knew him when I was really tripping, you know.
Yeah.
So
you can't miss that guy.
Yeah, he see a change in me. So I think that budget gonna be bigger now, you know.
Now we are live streaming this event, so let's talk about social media and all the things that have changed, you know, in the past 5 years. And for yourself, do you look at your Twitter? Do you look at your Instagram? Because you have a page. You know, do you look at that at all? Have you tweeted anything personally?
Nah, I ain't tweet yet.
Okay, what's gonna be your first tweet? Maybe we can tweet something. Where your phone? You got it on your Twitter?
No, I ain't got my phone. I probably tweet something just to the fans, thanking everybody for supporting me. But we won't do none of that until after the day, so. Mm-hmm. I might go on Instagram straight flexing today.
No, but you were trending on Twitter, you know, Instagram shut down. I was reading all the different things that happened, and they even said that, like, one person got an email from her teacher, like, classes are canceled, Boosie's home, you know.
Yeah, it was all on the Smoothie King, Boosie
yeah,
came
Yeah,
so the home.
Smoothie King, Boosie's
yeah,
home.
Yeah, yeah.
Was all of that a shock to you? Do you feel like since you came home, you're bigger than you were before you went in?
Yeah, I feel like that because I feel like a lot, you know, I already had millions of fans, but I feel like I got more fans because of social media, that my name was always in something. So I think a lot of people who didn't even buy CDs was like, let me check out this dude. You know, I'm tired of hearing about this dude. Let me check out his records. And that's how I get them. If you listen to my music, I'm gonna get you.
Right. And a lot of other artists really show you respect as well. You
yeah,
know, people
yeah.
really in the industry in general, and as well as just fans, so you get
right.
a lot of respect from everybody. Now, is there anybody that you're excited to work with now that you're home?
I just want to work with whoever. I got a hit for Justin Bieber. Yeah.
I don't know, he's a bad influence on you.
Nah. I'm about to coach him, you know? But I got a hit for Justin Bieber. And I just got music. I just got good quality street music.
Have you spoken to Justin Bieber?
Nah, I hope he's looking though.
He live in Atlanta now, so I'm so
sure.
Okay.
I'm gonna put you on the wrong. All right.
As far as traveling though, are you able to like travel, go on tour? What are the plans with that?
Well, we in talks about that now. Mm-hmm. I should be able to travel the last week in March.
Okay.
And
that's soon.
Yeah, that's soon. So I'll be doing my concerts. We're going to get the people from Atlantic to reach out to who they need to reach out to make this happen. James been on it. My brother been on it. TQ them. So it's going to make it happen because that's how I feed my family.
Right.
You know, you can't expect someone to come home and not feed his family.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we're going to make it work. I got a real nice P.O. I really like her. So we're going to make it work. We're going to make it work.
Got to show love to the P.O.
Yeah.
All right, and this is all being live streamed, as we said, on BoosieSpeaks.com. Now, what about the freestyle that you did when you were coming home? Did you know that was going to go as crazy as it did when it was filmed and put up? Who filmed that?
My brother, TQ.
TQ. And did you have any idea it was going to be such a big deal? Like, what has been the most surprising thing to you?
Oh, one girl saw me and said, this was surprising. She saw me and she said, oh my God, Jesus is back. She said, Jesus, they rose from the dead. That was surprising.
Okay, well, we do have some audience Q&As for you, okay? So we do have John Wirt from The Advocate who is here. John Wirt.
Hi, Boosie. Welcome back.
You
know, going to prison is a life-changing experience. Do you think you're a better, stronger,
artist and rapper than you were before you went into prison?
I feel I'm a better artist, you know. I got more stories to tell. See, my music always been based off telling stories. Now I really got a lot of stories to tell about my life, about what my family went through, what my people went through, and you know, I'm more versatile. You know, I'm a better artist, and I'm a better person because I'm wiser. You know, and I'm stronger, and I know who here for me and who ain't. So when you go to jail, you know who real and you know who ain't. So that was a blessing, even though I went through that. So of course I'm a better person and artist.
Did you feel good about the people that were holding you down, that were saying they were holding you down? Did you get a lot of surprise support from people? And there were people that you also saw that you thought would be helpful and weren't?
Yeah, I got a lot of that. Mm-hmm. I got a lot of love out there from the industry of, you know, Jesus. He was there for me the whole way, you know. Webby took my son fishing. I ain't never take my son fishing. Yeah. God had looked out for me, Plies. You know, I had a lot of dudes in the industry. Even if they said my name, I appreciate it, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
I hope you got a chance to see some of Webby's interviews, man. The guy is crazy. All right, Chelsea Brasted from NOLA.com and The Times. Picayune is here as well. So what's your question, Chelsea?
Hey, Boosie, good to see you.
Hey, how you doing, Chelsea?
Great. We have a reader question, actually. Someone wanted to know how, you know, it's been a couple of years since you've been out, obviously. So how do you plan to stay on top of the rap world? How have you evolved?
Really, as for the rap game, I feel like the music I got, the rap game wide open for me to take over. You know, I feel like what I've been hearing these last 3-4 days on the radio and stuff is different from my music. You know, like I said, it's different from my music, and different brings greatness, you know. So I just feel I stand alone in the music industry, tell you the truth. So that's how I think I stay on top.
And we also have Anastasia Simeon from Drum Newspaper. Anastasia.
Anastasia, but this is cool.
Anastasia.
Uh-huh. First of all, hey, Boosie.
Hey.
With everyone clamoring for a date and just kind of looping back around to your, you talked about your concerts. Are you saying that you're going to start them, like, possibly the end of March? And where can your fans go to get the official information?
We'll probably have that out this week.
And where will you have it? Like, on your website, on Twitter?
Yeah, on my website. Okay. But, you know, if you're trying to book a show, you gotta holler at my brother, you know, TQ, you trying to book a show. So that's about it on the shows, you know, but they calling. The phone busy, you know.
I'm sure.
The phone busy. I'm ready to perform, you know. I got a lot of stuff that
your
I never perform, you know. I never perform none of the mixtape stuff, the Super Bad, the Incarcerated. You know, I never did none of that stuff, so I'm ready to perform.
And you can go to BoosieSpeaks.com, that's official, so you can get all the information for all the dates and everything as well, you know.
You want to book a date? All right.
She's like, yes, we do. And shout out to Turk and Mel as well from Show Entertainment that are here as well.
You know. TML.
Yes. Okay, so we are going to have one-on-one interviews after this, so, you know, I guess you have those scheduled already, but I don't know if there's anything else you want to make sure that people know, you know, while everybody's watching. This is a worldwide streaming event on BoosieSpeaks.com.
Well, I just want to thank, you know, everybody in here, you know, even if some people in here wasn't my supporters, you know, I see a lot of people in here, but I just want to thank everybody for coming to this event, showing me love. First, I want to thank God, you know. Mm-hmm. I want to thank God for bringing me back, you know, because a lot of people counting me out, you know. He's still by me. I want to thank my family, everybody who supported me, everybody in this room right here. You know, if you're in this room, you somebody. You know, because a lot of people wanted to come in this room from all over. You know, they got plenty of people supporting me, the record labels, Jeezy, Tria, Turk and Mel. Turk did. Turkey, that nigga fool, man. TDM, youhating.com, they supported me. Boosie Justice, NAACP, Mr. Borkins, all them, man. I had some dudes fighting for me to get free, you know.
Right.
And it improved me, you know. It improved me going through all what I went through, because I went through some stuff in prison, man. And, you'll hear about that in the music.
I saw it, yeah.
So you ain't got to ask me what I went through. So, but I went through a lot of stuff, and that just made me a stronger person and know I can't be slipping. I got to do right, you know. And
I'm, yeah, I said they had you on 23-hour lockdown.
Yeah, 23-hour and 45-minute lockdown.
Damn.
Yeah.
What are you supposed to do for 15 minutes?
Use the telephone. Yeah. For 20 months.
That's awful.
Yeah.
All right, well, we are definitely glad to have you home. We're excited to hear the new music. The freestyle, I think, showed everybody that, you know, people were nervous. They were like, he went in jail. He's been gone for 5 years. Did he lose it? Is he going to come out? Is he going to sound rusty? But it sounded great.
I got the music for it. They just need to download it and go to the stores and get it. My music going to speak for me.
Over 1,000 songs. That's great.
Yeah.
At least you kept working. What about any books or anything like that? Where, you know?
Well, I wrote my own movie, Boosie the Movie. I'm just, I might shop it, but I'm probably going to get my own money and do it myself. But I'm going to try to put it in theaters, because it ain't no movie like this movie. This the real life story. I wrote my book. I don't know who I'm going to go through that with yet. Mm-hmm. I'm still fresh on the ground. I stayed busy in prison.
That's great.
So when I ain't had nothing to do, I try to, you know, mastermind another hustle.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much. And I guess the one-on-one interviews are about to start, but we appreciate you.
All right.
Boosie, welcome home again.
Don't peach my little girl.
What?
Don't peach my little girl.
All right, it's a celebration. Everybody act happy.
Hey, I'ma see if y'all listen to me all the other night, nigga. I'm the ugly girl, shit up. Hey, Locke, you know I love that old shit, nigga. You know that. Let's take them back when I ain't had no motherfucking jitter on. Let's go, DJ.
If you're just spinning by the thought that hoes are hurting you, that girl do anything to attract them hoes. Ain't got no window with their shirt off, throwing up the boat. This how it goes, you buy the clothes worth. You bet your girls worth. A nigga moves worth. I'm a girl's worth. You ain't never had shit. Swear up on them, fuck your daddy in the pen. Swear up on them, and your dad, I'm that gym dad. Swear up.
Hit his black and neck again. Y'all know I got enough music. We can do this shit to 6 a.m, nigga. I do it for y'all trap niggas out there, nigga. I'm a Project Baby, nigga. Believe that. Let's give some of that mixtape
shit. I won't make somebody pussy wet in this motherfucker.
Colors, it was navy blue. Fuck them hubcaps, I had to cop some 22s. Throwback 1952, like my nigga Boo. Some bowls too, now what's a fit without the shoes? $650 gear, mate, I'm fitted up. Press cut, all you niggas hoes getting fucked. Gas tank filled up, plus I'm grilled up. A couple fire ass blunts and a full cup. Fuck a expedition, me, I want a Benz truck. Skinny chick, suck a dick, I want a dick something. Fuck five figures, man, I hustle hard for six something. From noon to noon, soon I'm gonna be a rich something. What's conversation if a nigga can't just hit something? Why fuck a slime if you can fuck a nigga really thuggin'? If you gon' score and hustle, do it big then. You put it out in public buses, do it big then. If you gon' flip your buckets, you do it big then. If you can't get that Henny, you get some E&J. That Shell gas too high, and go to Circle K. Long as you doing it big, shit, you doing great. Bitch, you gon' show your ass, but gon' make it shake. If that's a fucking nail, then gon' make them hate.